to celebrate with all of you. More than 40 years of struggle in the Bay Area, around Puerto Rican political prisoners and Puerto Rico. And I say this because Prairie Fire started a tradition in this area of articulating a vision about whiteness and white skin privilege and challenged the entire left in this country to think about racism and colonialism as two faces of the same coin. And so for them, national liberation became a major test to deal with colonialism. A few months ago, Diana Black was in Chicago presenting her book. Yes, Diana. And Diana, someone asked her, how did you get involved in this Puerto Rican movement all the way in San Francisco? And Diana responded by saying, I was part of a movement that created a rich tradition of solidarity. And I come here tonight to express to you my gratitude, my deepest gratitude for that tradition of solidarity, that there is not a single movement in the United States that can say we have helped to free five generations of Puerto Rican political prisoners. On May 18th, and we welcome him celebrating 50 years of his legacy in that city of community building. And he was welcomed to La Casita de Don Pedro, Costolita de Ron, honored and dignified with her presence when we dedicated it 20 years ago. And he was met by an honor guard of 89 students who were graduating from Pedro Albizu Campos High School, which Oscar and I and a group of others, including some of the ex-political prisoners, helped to create 45 years ago. Women who struggle for a day and those who struggle all their lives, these are the indispensable ones. Claude Marx, Diana Black, Jody Sokol, Karen Shane, Bob, Rob McBride, Donna Wilmot, you are indispensable.
Thank you.